Happy 4th of July Sunday. Hello, live streamers, Facebook streamers. We miss you guys. Let's do this. Two.
Standing outside the door of love and mercy. You wonder if there's a place here for you. You know there's peace inside. Still you're searching for someone who understands the pain that you've been through. With the doors unlocked, the lights are on. What are you waiting for? Come on in, welcome home. You are love, you belong here now. No matter where you've been, just come on in. Oh yeah, yeah. You'll find a place of rest.
To all our Facebookers at Unity of Pompano Spiritual Center and to all of our live streamers at unitypompanobeach.org, we give you a big welcome. It's great to have you here. Happy Independence Day. We've come a long way from 1776 when you reflect on historically the attitudes and the ideas about ownership and freedom and possession of countries. We've come a long way, but we have a long way to go to live up to our ideals of freedom for everyone. So let us move forward with that intention as we celebrate a true Independence Day that can be ours as soon as we all pull together to make that happen. Maybe this is our year for Happy Independence Day. So as we start into our service this morning, I want to welcome our wonderful musicians under the direction of James McCoy.
Good morning. We have with us once again Mr. John Rose at the piano and the keyboard. We have Mr. Jeff Renza at the drum set this morning. Karina Iglesias is our featured soloist. And as we said, today is our 4th of July service, so it's all patriotic music today. Yep.
Very good. And I'm Bev Spivey. I'm happy to co-minister here with my husband, Reverend Lawrence Palmer, whom you'll be hearing from in just a little while. So let's begin by knowing that our theme for this entire year throughout the Unity Worldwide Movement is perfect vision, seeing through a spiritual lens. How do we do that? Well, we have to remind ourselves that our mind has many functions. And underneath it all is our connection with the one mind, which is God, the oneness of being together with each other. And so before we get too into our own little ideas of how things should be and could be, we lift our thoughts up to that divine mind realm of our higher power to where we can see that there are different perspectives, and yet there is a way for us to seek joy, peace, freedom, equality for all, as we put our thoughts on that intention. So continue to hold the perfect vision as we go throughout this year and, of course, beyond. But this month, we start a new theme. A monthly theme in Unity for July is play. Now, yesterday, Lawrence and I exhausted ourselves because the one thing we are able to do with our grandchildren that we don't have in our house or go in their house, it works to go into the pool. So Lawrence and I were in the pool 3 hours yesterday with three-year-old Leah, and we were too exhausted to even try to see fireworks last night. But for those of you who did celebrate, I hope you had that feeling of play. I know some of you were awake with barking and nervous dogs all night. So whatever your idea of play is, put it in operation today as you lift yourself into the mental attitude of play. And let's look at the affirmation we have for the entire month. I play in the zone, free and unrestrained. I play in the zone, free and unrestrained. Let's take that idea into prayer this morning. As we quiet our thoughts and we relax our mind, we relax our body, and we give ourselves permission to play in the zone right now of spiritual awareness, opening our heart and our mind to receive the inspiration of music and lesson, and the inspiration of meditation and prayer, and the inspiration of knowing that each and every one of us, from our location, wherever we are tuning in, is in a web, a network of spiritual community, opening to love and well-being for all. And so it is. Now, many of you know our opening hymn this morning, so if you'd like, sing along, "My Country, 'Tis of Thee." And as we begin today, we want to welcome those of you who maybe just have found us this week through an invitation of a friend or from happening across our Facebook page or our website. So welcome to all of you. We invite you to participate in all the things you have listed for Unity of Pompano Beach. And for those of you who are continuing with us, I believe, James, is this maybe our 17th week? Something like that.
I think you're right. I think it's 17, yeah.
I think we've done this for 17 weeks, and we thank you for continuing with us and making this spiritual community continue to be vibrant and alive. And as you pause in your prayer time every day to think of Unity of Pompano and your friends and acquaintances here, hold us all in prayer and you feel that energy flow, even from the distance of wherever you are in the moment. So I want to remind you that we are here to have prayer with you. There is a prayer request link on our website, unitypompanobeach.org. We have many prayer chaplains. I think we have 16 or 17. They would be happy to share your prayer in their hearts as they pray every day for our community, with Pompano community spiritually, but also other people. Send in whoever you would like for us to hold in prayer, and we would be happy to do that. Also, you can contact us with any other requests that you have, any concerns that you have. Our wonderful new and doing well director of operations is Susie Muth, and she is available for office business that you may need her for from Sunday through Thursday, about 9 to 4. You can reach her on unitypb@live.com. So stay in touch with us, won't you? We appreciate hearing from all of you. Well, some announcements for today. Even though we have no committees serving this morning, no ushers and greeters, no kitchen ladies in fellowship, and those of you who think that I'm, you know, just know that I'm joking. And it's really a dig at Lawrence, who one Sunday lapsed into his 40 years of ministry and starting out in the Baptist church and happened to refer to kitchen ladies, where a bunch of us jumped out of our seats and rebelled. So our fellowship team, and we have many others who serve in addition to our chaplains. So we're asking all of our ministry leaders to tune in to the Zoom link. You received it in your email this morning. We're asking you to phone in on that link or come in on your computer, and let's just touch base with each other. It's a way to keep in touch with our teams, and we won't be real lengthy on that meeting. We'll start at 12:30. We'll probably be done by 1. So we'll see you all this afternoon.
I think once everything is over with, I think the men have to get together for a meeting, and you know, the men who cook should get together and cook something, and we can call it the Kitchen Dudes.
So. The Kitchen Dudes, yeah. We got a bunch of great cooks in this congregation, I tell you what, men and women. So what do we have going on? Well, something new and exciting. Reverend Lawrence is teaching a class again, and I know many of you love to participate in his classes. So starting Tuesday evening at 7 o'clock, and for the next 4 Tuesdays, Lawrence will be teaching how to become a hyperhuman, not hyperactive, but how to live from that higher power and take advantage of the abilities and the powers that we know are ours, and yet we don't access them. So he's going to be dealing with stress, with illness, with aging, and with death. So please join us. The cost for his class is only $10 for each session. We would encourage you to save some time for you and for us if you just register for all 4 classes at once. There's an option to pay $40. This is all done online through our registration, which is on our website, unitypompanobeach.org. There's a link you just click. It'll take you right to the registration form. And I believe we have that on Facebook as well. So please, come on out on the next 4 Tuesday nights. And Lawrence and I will be on live from our living room, joining with those who want to entertain these ideas. And then, of course, our guided meditation continues Thursday nights at 7 o'clock. That, too, you can find the link on our website. And Power Hour, we had some challenges with technology this morning, and the internet was down. So Power Hour will resume again starting next Sunday at 9:30 and go for every Sunday. We would ask those of you who have been attending, because we've been doing this so many weeks, the Zoom link expired. So we would ask you to register once again for Power Hour. And if you see it that you can donate, we would encourage you to go ahead. And we're asking for a $10 love offering for Power Hour if you can. So please take advantage of everything we have going on. Sunday sessions will be next week, as Lawrence will entertain ideas and questions about the Sunday theme or anything else on your mind. That'll be next Sunday at 12:30 to 1:30. Again, of course, on Zoom. So now let's hear from our music team.
I picture something that's beautiful. It's full of life and it is all blue, yeah. I see a sunset on the beach, yeah. It makes me feel calm. When I'm calm, I feel good. And when I feel good, I sing. And the joy it brings makes me feel good. And when I feel good, I sing. Of the joy it brings.
Good morning, and I have the privilege of sharing the daily word with you today. And the word for today is comfort. Christ in me is my comfort. Experiences that move me out of my comfort zone are part of my life. The first day at a new school, starting or leaving a job, a new phase in a relationship, retiring from a career, the passing of a loved one. Any change can evoke discomfort, even grief. I grieve when I think of change as loss, loss of security, loss of my place in my community, or loss of love. The Christ, the divine presence of life, love, and wisdom within me, is my constant source of comfort through all of life's changes. I find assurance that although its physical expressions may change, life can never end. I know oneness and love with all who have been dear to me. Recognizing my divine nature, I know that there is no loss, change, or circumstance that can limit me, and I am comforted. From Psalm 71:21, you will increase my honor and comfort me once again.
Right now, we'd like to begin a time of prayer and meditation by singing, Spirit Meets Me There.
Wherever you may be, to find that comfortable and familiar position for your body. And as you easily settle into that position, you can give your body loving permission to relax, to let go, to let be. You can give that same permission to your mind, just to be present. Without processing. With body at ease and mind at ease, your awareness is free to commune with spirit. And on this day, as we are celebrating July 4th, Independence Day, we're very much focused on freedom. And I invite you to immerse yourself in the freedom that we have. As we prepare to enter into the stillness, you know that you are free to think whatever you need to think. You are free to feel whatever you need to feel. You are free to do whatever you need to do. All without judgment. We are free to be who we truly are. And as that spirit, that presence moves in and through us, we are guided to be the very best of who we are. And our thoughts, feelings, and actions match up with that best of who we are. We are enfolded, we are embraced, we are infused with the pure presence of spirit that holds that power of freedom. So as we have now prepared for the stillness, we allow our awareness to sink into that deep of our heart, that place of presence, that place of blessing, that place of love and light, that place of absolute oneness. And in that place, we will be together. Now, as you prepare to move your awareness back to your space and your time, you know that even an instant during which your awareness is immersed in that deep of your heart, that healing and transformation take place. And you know that you can bring into your body, into your heart, into your mind, the essence of this experience in the stillness. And in this coming week, as you choose to, as you need to, you can recall this experience and be blessed all over again. So with a deep sense of gratitude for this opportunity of being together in the stillness, I invite you to take a deep, slow breath in through your nose. Hold it for a moment. Exhale slowly, deliberately through your mouth. When you're ready, you can open your eyes and let us sing together, Alleluia.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
were beautiful. Four heroes proved in liberating strife, who more than sell their country love.
Well, as always, Ben, great job. Thank you so much. Very good. Well, I need to say happy Independence Day, happy 4th of July, even though this is the 5th of July, and we are one day past Independence Day. I'm sure that you all experienced fireworks and decorations and music and sales, always the 4th of July sales going on, and speeches and all kinds of things like that that usually happen. I trust that you got your share of that going. So here we are on the day after all of that. And before that passes into memory and passes into what has already gone by, I'd like for us to stop just a moment and think about where is our attention right now. Have we already left the idea of Independence Day and gone on to other things? Or is there something else that we need to look at? Now, there are a lot of significant things that came out of that period of time around July 4th, 1776. There was a brand new country that came, that was birthed during that time. The gestation had been going on for some time, but the painful birth happened, and finally, the Declaration of Independence was put out there. And then we had the Constitution of the United States that was compiled and enacted and ratified. So a lot of things happened during that period of time. I'd like to share with you the preamble to the Constitution. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. Now, if we stop right here and we're out of most of the emotion that comes up around all the celebrating on the actual 4th of July, if we look at this objectively, there's an interesting thing that comes up for me. That one phrase stands out, in order to form a more perfect union. Now, there was a great deal of effort and careful thought that went into writing this Constitution and all the documents came out of this time. And when this preamble was written, I suspect it was very, very deliberate, the wording here, where it says to form a more perfect union. It did not say to form the perfect union. It didn't say to do one thing for now and all time. It said a more perfect union than what has been. And for me, that phrase allows room for a more perfect union to be formed and at some time in the future, an even more perfect union to be formed, and sometime in the future, an even more perfect union to be formed. So it is a progressive, it's an ongoing experience. It's not something static that happens just one time and it's over. And we know that all the events that happened around this were not final. The documents were not complete. They served the time, they served the moment, but they were not complete. They were not perfect. They were a more perfect union than what had been before. We see some evidence that this document, these thoughts were not perfect, they were not complete, and that slavery was still there. And many of those who were involved in being the fathers of our country, as it were slaveholders. And we know that certainly was not a right thing, yet there it was as part of the culture at the time. And that was the more perfect that was formed at that time. Another indication that this progressive nature of what was happening here is that it only took 4 years before we realized that we needed amendments to the Constitution. The Bill of Rights was added only 4 years later after this more perfect document had been put together. So the Bill of Rights made it even a more perfect union. And along came other amendments down through the years, and a more perfect union and a more perfect union. So what I see here for us at this time as we celebrate Independence Day, and it is certainly appropriate to look back and to recall and remember and to honor what happened before. But I would like to point you toward looking forward, looking to what is not here yet, where we not have yet been, what has not yet happened, that more perfect union that we have not seen, we have not touched and tasted yet. It awaits us somewhere there. And that's where I want to point your attention, is that which is coming up in the future, that which is going to be. There was a quote that came to mind as I was thinking along these lines from Star Trek. I know many of you are Star Trek fans as I am. But at the end of each episode, there was this wonderful voice that said, "Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise, its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before." And I think that ties in so very well to this idea of a more perfect union, a continuously, progressively more perfect union, to go where no one has gone before. And I sincerely believe with all my heart that it is the duty, it is the destiny of each succeeding generation to form a more perfect union in that generation's context of situations and circumstances. Because that which is old will serve its purpose to a point. And it needs to be looked at again. It needs to be considered again. So each generation that comes along sees what is left out and goes about putting that in place. And we've seen that recently in the last few years. This younger generation that's coming along, that's further along than those before them have been, are standing up and saying no to things that are not right. And they're standing up and trying to create that which is true, that which is good. And I do so hope and pray that these young people will not lose that momentum and that they will go forward with recreating this more perfect union as they go along. So a series of questions I have for you. What if in our more perfect union, we have each other's backs for a change? What if with integrity and with reverence, we care for each other and we take care of each other and we hold each other's backs in challenging times? We see so much in our world now that is mean and hateful and judgmental and rejecting. And that does not work for us. That does not serve us. That does not support our highest good. So what if in our more perfect union, instead of attacking one another, we supported one another and we cared for one another? What if we turned our attention to the principles that are involved, and whether it's in our society, whether it's in politics, whether it's in business, what if we turned our attention more to principle than to personality? I remember hearing as I was growing up that you can disagree without being disagreeable. I hear my daddy saying that down through the years. And that comes into play here, that when we support each other and care for each other, we don't have to agree. We don't have to be alike one another. But if the principle is there in which we can agree on, we can support one another, we can care about one another, and let go of the meanness and the hate, the name-calling, the assassinations of character that go on. What if in our more perfect union, we are able to hold each other accountable, but to do so with compassion and respect? Now, we all make mistakes. Another old saying that came to mind as I was going through this is, even a broken clock is correct twice a day. So all of us are right at one time or another. All of us are wrong at one time or another. Matter of fact, there's a wonderful quote. John, if you put that up for me. There is so much good in the worst of us and so much bad in the best of us that it ill behooves any of us to find fault with the rest of us. That makes really a lot of sense to me. So we look at each other and we hold each other accountable, but do so with compassion, with care, with respect. And we all can learn from that. Because as we all make mistakes, rather than being judged and punished, if in that mistake we have someone who holds us accountable in a caring way, I think that will change our world and it will take us to that more perfect union. What if in our more perfect union, we embrace nonpartisanship? Now, as you hear the news from Washington, you hear about partisanship a lot. And partisanship means taking sides. And it usually means that my side's right and your side's wrong. And everybody needs to be where I am. And there's a lot of that going around. That happens. But what if we were able to let that go? Yeah, I think it's a sad commentary that when we hear on the news that there was some kind of bipartisan legislation passed, we're amazed. We think, wow, this is wonderful, this is great. Well, that's what's supposed to happen. It's a sad commentary that we get so excited about something that's supposed to be happening in the first place, because it is so unusual that we have true bipartisan involvement in our leadership. But I would opt for something I've called omnipartisan. What if everyone gets to be involved? What if everyone's opinion is considered? I was attending a board meeting of what was then the Association of Unity Churches many years ago. I was on the board, and somebody started to say something and someone else stopped them, and I can't remember who the president was at the time, but the president of the board said, no, every opinion will be valued here. Every comment will be allowed. And I thought, that's the way it's supposed to be. What if we had omnipartisanship? That is, everyone was on the same side, and everyone was respected, and everyone was listened to. What if that were our more perfect union? What if in our more perfect union, we rejected discrimination in all shapes and sizes? We see it in our world today. There is racism, there's bigotry, there's misogyny and social phobias, all being in the name of being right. And unfortunately, many of them being used in the name of Christianity and religion. What if we chose not to do that anymore? What if we let go of those things and in the place put honoring of all people, no matter who they are, no matter their choice of life, no matter their color, their creed, all of those things that separate so much now? What if all those things were embraced underneath the oneness? We hear this idea of oneness in the language of these early documents of our country. We hear it in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. One nation under God. One nation. What if we were able to do that and that were our more perfect union? What if in our more perfect union, we learned from the past? We saw what fear could do. And I've come to believe that behind the hate, behind the bigotry, behind the misogyny, there is fear. Fear of someone being smarter than me. Someone being right and making me wrong. Well, one way to protect that is to attack, is to be angry, is to be hateful. And what if we were able to learn from the past? We could see what fear does to us. We could see what ego does to us and be able to say, we are not going to do that in this generation. Our more perfect union does not include those things. What if we truly learned from the past? And what if in our more perfect union, we began to live from spiritual principle? This is one of the things I'll be speaking about in the class that's coming up on Tuesday night, becoming hyperhuman. What if our primary point of reference is that of spirituality, and everything flowed from that point out through our humanness into our world? What if that were our more perfect union? All these are possible for us. Now, sometimes I fear that our current situation would be very much like an Old Testament situation. If you've read your Bible, and I know many of you have, I've encouraged people along the way to read through the Bible every year. I've read through it I don't know how many times now. There's some great stories in there, but one of the stories is about when the Hebrews left Egypt. They were freed as slaves, and they were going back to the Promised Land. They were going home. And when they got out in the desert and things got tough and they missed all their great Egyptian food, they began to complain. And what really happened was that they had to stay out there in the wilderness, roaming around without a home until the generation that knew about Egypt died off. And the next generation took them on to the Promised Land and took them home. And I do so pray that that is not the situation that has to be with us. That the generation who created the more perfect union that we've seen in the past don't have to die away before we can move forward. I hope that they can embrace what comes along as these young people move along in places of leadership and take us where we've never been before. I do so pray that those who have come before us will embrace that and move along as well. What if our more perfect union takes us to a place where we've never, ever been before? And what if we are able to feel things we've never felt before, think things we've never thought before, and do things we've never done before because of this more perfect union that we bring into reality? So what if in our more perfect union, we boldly go where no one has gone before? God bless you and happy 4th of July.
Oh my goodness. That is our unity message. And it's good to hear it and remember it. We can form a more perfect union day by day by day with each of us standing in integrity, coming from our higher mind to choose what's best for all, for our nation. Perhaps it won't be for me individually. So that's our challenge as we move forward. So Lawrence's message and our entire live stream, including the music, will be on unitypompanobeach.org throughout this week. You can always find it on Facebook also at Unity Pompano, Unity of Pompano Spiritual Center. So after this week, when we have another live stream on our website, the podcast will still be there of Lawrence's lesson. You just click on services and you'll see the podcast and you just go to July 5th. So let's do what we can to hold that ideal in our hearts. And right now I want to thank you for those who are continuing to sustain us with your financial gifts. We have cut back on all of our expenses. We aren't even ordering any kind of supplies. We're just going ahead with what we have and covering our basic expenses, our utilities and staff. And many of you have continued to send in your financial support. So I want to thank you for that, because truly it enables us to keep going. We did have a bit of an advantage from the payroll protection plan, and that program is over as of this week. And so we go forward knowing that you will continue to support Unity of Pompano so that we can continue to put our message out there as we form this more perfect union, a union of spiritual living. So won't you hold your gift in your hand and recognize that we have many ways to give here. And if you don't have a gift in your hand symbolically, we invite you to take a look at the different ways. Of course, you can always send in your check to the church address that's on the website. There's a donate button right there, easily accessible, where you can set up a one-time or a recurring gift. You can use your online bill pay with your bank. That's really very easy, and it doesn't cost you or us anything, although we do not mind paying your credit card fee if that's easiest for you to just send in your gift. And so we have the text to give number that's also there on your screen, 954-280-1031. And we had a reminder also to sign up through Amazon and donate to us through there. So thank you for the many ways you give. And I believe many of you know this blessing. I always read it because when I don't have it in front of me, in spite of doing it for years, I tangle up the words. So hold in your hearts now the idea of giving. Whether you have any financial gift to give today or not, there are many ways we can give in this world. So think about being a gift giver and not a taker today as we bless our offering. With a grateful heart, we acknowledge God as source of all that is. Today we let go of any concern of lack, and we allow good to unfold in our lives. Good is ours. Good and more good is ours. An ever-increasing good is ours. Everywhere we go, we see this good. We feel it. We experience it. We freely give it. And it multiplies itself around us. And so it is. Amen.
This land is your land, this land is my land, California, New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking, ribbon a highway, I saw above me, then in the skyway, I saw below me, Golden Valley. This land was me, you and me. I roamed and rambled, followed my footsteps to the sparkling sands of her diamond deserts. All around me, a voice was sounding, this land is made for you and me. When the sun came shining, I was strolling, the wheat fields waving, the dust clouds rolling. As the fog was lifting, a voice was chanting, this land is made for you and me. Nobody living can ever stop me, 'cause I go walking that freedom highway. Nobody living can ever make me turn back, 'cause this land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land. California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. This land was made for you and me. This land was made for you and me.
Wow, we have a wonderful land, don't we? It's beautiful all across the country. And we see each and every one of you wherever you are, and we embrace all of your family and loved ones and acquaintances throughout this wonderful land. And we invite you to enjoy this day and enjoy our spiritual community here. So let's close today with our unity blessing for each other, as written by James Della Freeman. The light of God surrounds us. We are the light of God. The love of God enfolds us. We are the love of God. The power of God protects us. We are the power of God. The presence of God watches over us. We are the presence of God. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well.
blessings are falling like a sweet, sweet rain. Blessings are falling, are falling, are falling on me. Beauty is falling, is falling, is falling. Beauty is falling like a sweet, sweet rain. Beauty is falling, is falling, is falling on me. Oh Lord, I receive your blessing. Oh Lord, I receive your grace. Oh Lord, I will dance forevermore. Oh Lord, I receive your blessing. Oh Lord, I receive your grace.